Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to an episode of Spitting Venom, aka the Venom Vlog. Thank you guys for being so patient with me as I work through these videos. I actually slept all day. It's almost 8 p.m. now, and I've been asleep since, like, I think since I uploaded the episode 201 earlier. So got about a good, like, 8 hours of sleep. So I am a little bit rested. I'm feeling a lot better. I think I just needed to take some medicine and have an actual day of pure rest. And I feel 10 times better than I did when I woke up this morning. So thank you guys for hanging in there with me. I hope you enjoyed that last video where we looked at the photos. I got a lot of views on it, so I appreciate you guys supporting that and checking it out. And I appreciate all the thumbs up and likes very much. But like I said in that video, there's still more information to cover. We just talked about the pictures in that one, but Entertainment Weekly also dumped a bunch of movie news on us and some quotes from these guys. And like some of these movie news things, I don't know if they're 100% true. Like, you know, the way they wrote this article, it makes it sound factual, but you never really know what they're implementing themselves or what they gleaned themselves or what they, you know, translated from a comment themselves. So you don't fully really know. So I'm still going to break this up into two more videos. So in this video, we're going to talk about the comments made by Ruben Fleischer, and we're going to talk about those parts of the article. And then the next video, we're going to talk about the stuff that Tom Hardy said and that the article says in general, because there are some interesting things in there, especially plot-wise, and I thought that would make for a good separate video. But for this one, we're going to talk about Ruben Fleischer's comments, and I have my trusty Kindle Fire here so we can take a look at it. And I'm on Entertainment Weekly's website. I have the link down below if you want to check it out. So we have some comments here from Ruben Fleischer, and here we go. I'm going to just read it real quick. It says, "The film leans heavily into Venom's violent tendencies. Have you seen those teeth?" Which, yes, they look awesome. "As well as the body horror that comes with sharing your skin with an alien. Informing this Venom, director Ruben Fleischer from Zombieland explains." And he says, and I quote, "We talked a lot about a werewolf and what it is like when you get infected or bit by a werewolf." And this is really great because I always go back to like American Werewolf in London and that awesome transformation scene and the body horror element, which is something that stuck with me as a kid, you know, seeing something like that. When I think of, you know, two aliens sharing the same body, I keep thinking of John Carpenter's The Thing, or even The Fly with, you know, Cronenberg and directed The Fly. And you had Jeff Goldblum, you know, turning into this creature because he kind of bonded and, you know, mutated along with a fly that got into his little capsule, his teleportation capsule. So when I think about body horror, I think about stuff like that as well as werewolf stuff, because it is a complete transformation of your body. Although a man may transform into a wolf or Jekyll may transform into Hyde, Eddie Brock and Venom don't really switch from one to another. Instead, they occupy the same body at the same time and have to reluctantly learn how to coexist, which is something we talked about recently in one of the comics that we did in our discussion video in episode 200, where Eddie is explaining to Angelo what it's going to feel like when he bonds with the symbiote, and that it's going to take time for the symbiote to learn how to meld with his lungs and learn how to breathe along with, you know, Eddie, or, you know, Angelo in this case. And he talks about how you have to really be in sync with this other being and how painful, especially the first time, is. And that's really crazy. And it definitely adds that horror and sci-fi element to it. But then we also have another quote here saying, "Usually a human gets imbued with powers, or an alien comes from outer space and has to figure out how to live on Earth," Fleischer says. "But this is really about a relationship between two people who have to work together to create the hybrid symbiotic relationship." So yeah, this is just cool stuff. I mean, hearing them think about it on that level just shows you how much work and thought that goes into this. And sometimes things like this don't translate to the movie. So that's why articles and getting information out there early is so important, so that you kind of temper expectations. You get people thinking on that mindset, so when they go in, they're aware of that. They're like, hey, you know, we have like a 2 hour, you know, 2 hours to tell this story, and some things are going to be there visually in front of you, but you might not pick up on it. So we do these articles and we do these interviews to tell you what our inspirations were and why we're going in this direction, so you can understand why we're making the decisions that we're making. And that's why articles and interviews and everything are so important to marketing of a movie, and also just getting people's head to wrap around the concept in general. Because for some people, especially comic fans, hardcore ones, wrapping their head around a Venom movie without Spider-Man is a hard pill to swallow. But for a lot of us who are just intrigued and like Tom Hardy and like the look of the movie so far, It's a little bit of easier sell, but it's still good to hear the reasoning behind stuff. I learned this lesson at work recently when it comes to like when it comes to giving feedback to an employee, because now I'm a supervisor, so I have to be like a boss at times. And so I've never really been really great at that. So I've been trained lately to give a reason why I'm giving feedback. And I think a lot of people do respond to that. It's good to know the why. So if you say, hey, here's why I am giving this feedback and why it's important we do it a certain way, it's like, oh, and people seem to be less confrontational, because I know it's hard to get feedback at work if someone's telling you to do something wrong, or, you know, you immediately get defensive, you think you're doing everything right, but it's good to just hear that feedback and listen to what people are saying, so that way you can find a good middle ground and find a way to, you know, get improve if you can. So, you know, I like this. I like hearing about all this stuff, and I'm getting excited. I'm getting more excited for this movie. And there's a lot more stuff that Tom Hardy says and the article says in general about the plot of the film that we will definitely talk about in the next episode, which I'll record right now, and I'll get up immediately after this video. So go watch that if you can, please. Thank you so much for watching my show. As always, let me know what you think of these comments down below. Are you interested in the body horror element? Are you interested in, you know, the idea of two things sharing and occupying the same space and having to work together? That seems so awesome to me, and it's so great that they put that much thought and work into the creation of this movie. That just makes me more excited to go see it, and makes me feel like it's not just, you know, like everyone's like, oh, it's a cash grab. It's like, well, every movie is, but it's good to see that the filmmakers are putting this kind of thought into the movie. But still, let me know what you think in those comments down below. Thanks for watching my show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you in the future. Peace.